Hi, good morning, Anna. Thanks for tuning into the Breakfast News on Rajya Sabha Television this Thursday morning. My name is Aishwarya Kapoor. Let us start the news with the headlines. Short duration discussion on recent increase in MSP of Kharif crops and challenges in agriculture sector slated in Rajya Sabha today. The National Medical Commission Bill 2017 on Lok Sabha's list of business. Fulfilling hopes and aspirations of people, criterion for the success of parliamentary system, says President Ram Nath Kovind. At award ceremony to honour outstanding parliamentarians, a vice president says parliamentary democracy will flourish if government is responsive and opposition responsible. Prime Minister says nation and not government at loss due to disruptions. Sovereignty and citizenship are the soul of India, while imported vote banks are not, says Union Minister Arun Jaitley, targeting Congress and TMC over the Assam NRC issue. TMC says citizenship not a gift that can be handed over or taken back. Party's 8-member delegation to visit Assam today. United Arab Emirates launches landmark 3-month visa amnesty program. Illegal foreign workers overstaying permits will be allowed to leave without penalties and get 6 months to find a job. And India to take on Ireland in the quarterfinals of the Women's Hockey World Cup in London today. In cricket, R. Ashwin's 4 wickets for 60 runs reduce England to 285 for 9 on the first day of the first test at Edgbaston. A week left for the monsoon session of Parliament to conclude, and there is heavy legislative agenda slated in both houses of Parliament today. In the Rajya Sabha, Amit Shah and 8 other members will raise a short duration discussion on the recent increase in MSP for Kharif crops and challenges in the agriculture sector. Also, 7 bills are slated to be taken up in the upper house, including the introduction of the DNA Technology Use and Application Regulation Bill 2018. And in the Lok Sabha, among the bills to be taken up for consideration is the National Medical Commission Bill 2017 and the National Sports University Bill 2018. And Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu on Wednesday expressed anguish at the manner in which House proceedings were disrupted on Tuesday. He also gave a vent to his distress at some members running menacingly towards the well of the House, and Chairman Naidu refrained from naming any member but sought cooperation from all the members for the smooth functioning of the House. He also exuded hope that such incidents will not be repeated, even as he asserted that the chair has the power to adjourn the house depending on the situation.
Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu expressed his anguish at the disruptions in the house that prevented the Home Minister from making his reply on the crucial Assam NRC issue.
I was so upset yesterday, so much so the country also, when some members menacingly rushed towards the well of the house. I thought something is going to happen to my secretariat. And then some people started raising slogans also. It's totally unacceptable. I hope such things will not be repeated. I don't want to name anybody or take any party's name, because I saw in the newspapers saying that house is going on well, lot of constructive business has been done, and but now it will not be allowed. Like that, one day before, in the newspapers it came. Subsequently, what has happened, have happened. Let me make it very clear. The chair has power to adjourn the house as per the situation. And there are umpteen number of examples in this house, in the very house, from the chair, where the house is adjourned, and then to any time. One, that is the discretion of the chair, because he is the overall responsible for the conduct of the house in a dignified and manner. But unless there is a cooperation by all members, it's not possible. So when I find it not possible, the next thing I do is, instead of allowing this unruly scenes to be seen by the people, because this is Parliament, this is the upper house, where people expect a more matured behavior by one and all. I don't want that negative thing to go. That's why I adjourned the house and I adjourned it. As far as the house is concerned, it should be conducted in a dignified manner, befitting of the upper house of Indian Parliament, which has got a greater seat.
On Tuesday, the Rajya Sabha witnessed protests after BJP MP Amit Shah claimed that the Congress didn't have the courage to implement NRC despite signing the Assam Accord in 1985. He also sought to know if the opposition wishes to save illegal infiltrators and immigrants. Kriti Mishra, Rajya Sabha TV.
The opposition members stalled a zero hour for the third day in a row on Wednesday. And Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu sought the cooperation of all the members for a constructive debate and discussion in the House.
0 hour was stalled on the third consecutive day on Wednesday due to protests by opposition members. Anand Sharma of the Congress highlighted the statement of BJP MP Amit Shah that Congress did not have the courage to implement NRC despite signing the Assam Accord in 1985 through a point of order.
एक माननीय सदस्य के द्वारा कि राजीव गांधी जी के असम अकॉर्ड के बाद जितने प्रधानमंत्री थे वो बुजदिल थे, उनमें हिम्मत नहीं थी. मैं इसकी निंदा करता हूं, उसको आप वापस करें, उसको क्षमा मांगे, रिकॉर्ड से निकालें. आपने कैसे कह दिया?
राइट राइट राइट
सर, नो, कल उसको स्पंज नहीं किया गया.
ठीक है,
ये बड़े दुख की बात है कि सदन में ये बात हुई. इस सदन में अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी जी भी आपके प्रधानमंत्री थे.
As BJP MP Amit Shah rose to conclude his speech, opposition members caused disruptions. Chairman Venkaiah Naidu made fervent appeals to allow the House to function, but the members refused to relent. Then the chairman adjourned the House till noon.
The House is adjourned immediately at 12 p.m.
On Monday and Tuesday, Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu had requested Home Minister Rajnath Singh to be present in the House to assuage the fears of members. But the issue could not be taken up due to continued disruptions. Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And the opposition members continued to protest even after the House reconvened after lunch. Trinamool Congress members forced the adjournment of the Rajya Sabha for the day as it failed to complete a discussion on Assam's National Register of Citizens.
Opposition members continued to disrupt the Rajya Sabha for the third day in a row on the National Register of Citizens of Assam issue. When the House reconvened at 2 p.m. after the lunch break, TMC's Sukhendu Shekhar Roy raised a point of order as BJP President Amit Shah was asked to conclude his speech that he had started on Monday. Responding to the point of order, Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu said he had allowed Shah to complete his speech that could not be completed yesterday due to continued disruptions.
If any member who is so called upon does not speak, he shall not be entitled except with the permission of the chair. Here, in this case, one honourable member has already spoken. How can he speak twice?
That's not a point of order, please. There is no point of order because he was on his legs. He was not allowed to complete. I have permitted him to complete.
Expressing his displeasure, Chairman Naidu said the conduct of the protesters was unbecoming of parliamentarians. He then again asked Amit Shah to speak, but the disruptions continued. Amid the disruptions, BJP President Amit Shah said if the opposition had issues with his speech, he will not speak. Home Minister Rajnath Singh sought the chair's permission to table his speech, saying some members did not wish to hear the reply to the discussion on the NRC. Thanking the Home Minister for coming to the House for three consecutive days, Chairman Naidu adjourned the House for the day.
I am adjourning the House to meet at 11 a.m. tomorrow.
With inputs from Panchanan Mishra, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And according to sources, after Congress leader Anand Sharma said in the House that BJP MP Amit Shah should apologize for saying that no Prime Minister since Rajiv Gandhi and those after him had the courage to implement the NRC in Assam and the House was adjourned, the chairman examined the record of verbatim proceedings of the House and it was revealed that Amit Shah did not make any such references to other Prime Ministers during his speech on Tuesday. Meanwhile, in the House, Chairman Venkaiah Naidu complimented the members for a productive question hour. The upper house transacted 12 of the listed 15 starred questions for oral replies. This was only for the second time when these many starred questions were taken up by the Rajya Sabha for oral answers. Earlier this year, Rajya Sabha took up all listed 15 starred questions for oral replies in January during the winter session. And the Lok Sabha passed the Commercial Courts, Commercial Division and Commercial Appellate Division of High Courts Amendment Bill 2018 on Wednesday. The bill amends the law for speedy disposal of commercial disputes and seeks to reduce the pecuniary jurisdiction of commercial courts from 1 crore rupees to 3 lakh rupees. Replying to the debate on the bill, Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad said that the bill is aimed at ensuring India's performance in the ease of doing business. The bill, which was passed by a voice vote in the Lok Sabha, allows the state governments to establish commercial courts at the district level. The Law Minister also said that there should be higher representation of those belonging to SC, ST, OBC and minority communities in the higher judiciary.
This is one step. Tomorrow or day after, I am coming with arbitration law, also the New Delhi Centre of Arbitration. Because all these things are designed to make India a good hub of domestic arbitration and international arbitration for resolution of dispute. So it is a whole package this government is going. And when India is emerging as a big economic powerhouse, surpassing even France, on way to become the top three, sir, these measures are important.
And President Ramnath Kovind presented the Outstanding Parliamentarians Award to 5 members of Parliament yesterday at a function held in the Central Hall of Parliament. The President conferred the Outstanding Parliamentarian Award to Dr. Najma Abdullah for the year 2013, Hukumdev Narayan Yadav for 2014, Leader of Opposition in Rajya Sabha Ghulam Nabi Azad for the year 2015, TMC MP Dinesh Trivedi for 2016 and BJD MP Bharatruhari Mahatab for 2017. The names of these MPs were shortlisted by a committee headed by Lok Sabha Speaker Sumitra Mahajan.
इसीलिए सामान्य जनता यह देखना चाहती है कि उसके प्रतिनिधि सदैव उसके कल्याण में कार्यरत रहें। जनता यह भी अपेक्षा करती है कि संसद में उनकी कठिनाइयों के समाधान तथा देश के विकास पर चर्चा हो। उनकी आशाओं पर खरा उतरना ही हमारी संसदीय व्यवस्था की सफलता की कसौटी है। जनमानस की अपेक्षाओं के अनुरूप आचरण करने में ही संसदीय लोकतंत्र की मर्यादा है।
Government has to be responsive and the opposition has to be responsible. Then only parliamentary democracy will succeed. So let us remember these principles that one, be tolerant towards the mandate of the people. Two, let the opposition have its say and the government have its way. Let the government propose, opposition oppose and let the house dispose. If you follow this, then definitely the parliamentary democracy will succeed.
हम सबका दायित्व है कि हमारे हर सांसद साथी का शब्द चिरंजीव बने। हम सबका दायित्व है कि हमारे शब्द सांसद के दिल से निकली हुई वो गांव गरीब किसान की बात सरकार को कुछ करने के लिए मजबूर करें। ये स्थिति सदन में हम सब पैदा कर सकते हैं और जितना अच्छे ढंग से पैदा करेंगे देश को आगे ले जाने में उसकी ताकत और बढ़ेगी।
लोकतांत्रिक व्यवस्था के लिए हमेशा हम कहते हैं मतांतर हो सकता है मगर विचार विमर्श की एक जगह वहाँ है, गुंजाइश है। सहमति असहमति के बीच कहीं ना एक कहीं एक व्यवस्था हमें देना है। ये लोकतंत्र की, प्रजातंत्र की भी खासियत है। और दूसरी बात है, संसद की गरिमा को अक्षुण्ण हमें रखना है, ये हम सबका काम है।
हर प्राइम मिनिस्टर ने अपने टाइम पे कुछ न कुछ कहा होगा मगर नरेंद्र मोदी जी ने जो बात कही, सबका साथ सबका विकास, वो सही माने में हमारे संविधान को ट्रांसलेट करता है इन रियल सेंस।
लोगों को ये आश्चर्य लगता है कि मैं ऑल इन वन कैसे बन गया, मैं स्वयं सेवक भी बन गया, समाजवादी भी बन गया, लोहियावादी भी बन गया, चरण सिंह के साथ भी, कर्पूरी ठाकुर के साथ भी, और दीनदयाल जी का भी गीत गाता हूँ। तो भाई हिंदुस्तानी हूँ मैं, इस देश में सर्वधर्म समभाव है, सर्व समाज समभाव है। दीनदयाल जी कहते थे समरस समाज, डोड़िया कहते थे समता समाज, इसलिए मैंने उसको अपने जीवन में अंगीकार किया है।
आज हम देखते हैं कि कितनी छोटी छोटी बच्चियों का बलात्कार हो रहा, किस तरह से लोग झूठी अफवाहों पे लोग मारे जा रहे हैं, ये बड़ा चिंता का विषय है देश के लिए। और चिंता हमें यहां करनी है, इस परिवार यहां, ये सबसे बड़ा घर है और न्याय दिलाने वाला घर है। यहां कानून दुनिया में सुप्रीम कोर्ट इंटरप्रेट कर सकती है लेकिन कानून नहीं बना सकती, उस हिसाब से तो ये सुप्रीम कोर्ट से भी ऊपर है।
हमें सोचना है कि हमारी आने वाली पीढ़ी को हम क्या छोड़ के जाएंगे, ये बहुत जरूरी है। ये लोकतंत्र का मंदिर की नींव को मजबूत बनाना हम सबका कर्तव्य है। इस मंदिर की पूजा अर्चना तभी संभव हो सकती है जब हम साधारण नागरिक के सुर के साथ अपना सुर मिलाते हैं।
दिस अवार्ड हैज कम एट अ टाइम व्हिच हैज एश्योर्ड मी दैट द ट्रस्ट द पीपल हैव ऑन मी इज बीइंग रिवॉर्डेड एंड हैज इंट्रस्टेड ग्रेटर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑन माई शोल्डर टू सर्व द पीपल एंड बी देयर वॉइस in this temple of democracy.
And in breakfast news, so we'll take a very short break here. Stay with us.
लंबे समय से आपकी मांग रही है कि कला, साहित्य, संगीत, नृत्य और सिनेमा की सांस्कृतिक हलचलें आप तक हिंदी में भी पहुंचे। राज्यसभा टीवी पर अब हम आपको परिचित कराएंगे संस्कृति, परंपरा और आधुनिकता के सभी कला रूपों से हर सप्ताह हिंदी में भी। आपकी सांस्कृतिक डायरी, कला, साहित्य, सिनेमा, संगीत और नृत्य का झरोखा सबरंग जल्द आ रहा है सिर्फ राज्यसभा टीवी पर।
Welcome back after the break. Union Minister Arun Jaitley has accused Congress President Rahul Gandhi and West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee of playing with India's sovereignty on the Assam NRC issue. In a hard-hitting Facebook post titled National Register of Citizens, Sovereignty versus Vote Bank, he added that sovereignty and citizenship are the soul of India and not imported vote banks. Arun Jaitley accused Rahul Gandhi of taking a fringe position with regard to the NRC in Assam, which is a contrarian to what was advocated by former Prime Ministers Indira Gandhi and Rajiv Gandhi. He further said that the principal duty of any government is to defend its borders and prevent any trespass. He also accused Mamata Banerjee of changing her position on the issue of Bangladeshi infiltration. In response, TMC leader Derek O'Brien said that while sovereignty without doubt is the soul of India, secularism is the inner conscience of the country. Meanwhile, in related news, an 8-member delegation of the Trinamool Congress will be visiting Assam from today to assess the situation following the final draft of the NRC. The delegation will be visiting the state today and tomorrow. Meanwhile, the Assam government has said that Mamata Banerjee's opposition to the Supreme Court-monitored NRC amounted to contempt of court and she is not above the apex court. The state government also said that Banerjee's allegations are baseless and that it will see at an appropriate time whether to file a contempt court of case against her. It also said that if the visiting TMC team tries to disturb the peace in the state of Assam, the government will not remain a mute spectator. And West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee on Wednesday earlier met UPA Chairperson Sonia Gandhi and Congress President Rahul Gandhi in Delhi. Post-meeting, Mamata Banerjee said that they discussed the possibility of contesting elections together in future against the Narendra Modi-led BJP government ahead of the 2019 Lok Sabha elections. The NRC Assam issue was also discussed at the meet. The TMC chief also met Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal and discussed political strategies to counter the BJP in the 2019 general elections. She also invited opposition leaders to attend her rally on 19th of January in Kolkata. Besides the leaders from the Congress, TDP, DMK, RJD, SP and JDS, Mamata Banerjee also met with senior BJP leader LK Advani and Shiv Sena leader Sanjay Raut. On to some other news. The Union Cabinet has decided to restore a provision of the SC-ST Act allowing the arrest of an accused without preliminary inquiry or prior approval. Apart from this, the Cabinet also approved a dilution of a government shareholding in IDBI Bank Limited to below 50%. It also decided to open 13 central schools in the country. Here are the details.
Accepting a key demand of Dalit groups, the Union Cabinet on Wednesday gave its nod to a bill to restore the original provisions of the Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribes Prevention of Atrocities Act. The decision comes days before a Bharat Band called by Dalit leaders on the 9th of August. The bill is expected to be introduced in the ongoing monsoon session of Parliament. Earlier this year, the Supreme Court had introduced changes in the law that were criticized by Dalit leaders and organizations.
This baat ka khushi hai. कि कैबिनेट ने जो है जो बिल था पहले का पूर्ववत क्या कहते उसी बिल को जो है बिना कॉमा फुल स्टॉप चेंज किए हुए रखा है और हाँ जल्द से जल्द सरकार क्या कहते हैं कि जो है जिस कैबिनेट के निर्णय को पार्लियामेंट के में क्या कहते हैं कि लाएगी बिल पेश करेगी और हमको लगता है क्या कहते हैं कि जो है सर्वसम्मति से ये बिल जो है बहुत जल्दी पास हो जाएगा
ने एक और बहुत महत्वपूर्ण फैसला किया है लेकिन संसदीय परंपरा का सम्मान करते हुए हम उसको आपके सामने बता नहीं सकते क्योंकि बिल ला करके हमको संसद के सामने बताना है जस्ट अ मिनट एक बात हम अवश्य कहेंगे नरेंद्र मोदी जी की सरकार इस देश के दलितों और हमारे आदिवासी भाइयों के विकास के लिए कृत संकल्प है और उस दिशा में जो भी उचित कार्रवाई करने की आवश्यकता होगी पहले भी की है आगे भी करेगी
In another decision, the Cabinet cleared the purchase of 51% controlling stake in IDBI Bank by Life Insurance Corporation. LIC, which already has 7-7.5% stake in the bank, will acquire the remaining for majority holding. The proposed acquisition by LIC will give the debt-ridden bank capital support between 10,000 crore rupees to 13,000 crore rupees, depending on the share price of the bank.
Deal is going to be an excellent deal for LIC. It opens up 1,916 branches of IDBI, where LIC and its 11 lakh agents will be able to market the various policies of LIC. It will open up LIC's deployment of funds, putting it to good use through housing loans.
The Cabinet also approved GST law amendments that included hiking threshold limit for availing composition scheme dealers to 1.5 crore rupees. The government will now table amendments to the Central GST Law, Integrated GST Law, Compensation Cess Law in the ongoing monsoon session of Parliament. With inputs from Pancharan Mishra, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
An External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj will embark on a three-nation Central Asia tour from today. During her four-day visit, she will visit Kazakhstan, the Kyrgyz Republic and Uzbekistan. The External Affairs Minister will be in Kazakhstan today, where she will hold a bilateral meeting with the Kazakh Foreign Minister, call on the leadership of the country and interact with the Indian community there. In a statement, the MEA said India and Kazakhstan have a strategic partnership and multifaceted relations that have been strengthened by the visits of Prime Minister Narendra Modi to Kazakhstan in 2015 and 2017. It added that there have also been meetings on the margins of SCO summits, keeping the momentum in the growth of bilateral relations. And after Kazakhstan, Sushma Swaraj will be in the Kyrgyz Republic on 3rd and 4th of August. And on the 3rd and the last leg of her visit, Sushma Swaraj will be in Uzbekistan. A top international focus, the UAE on Wednesday launched a landmark 3-month visa amnesty program for visa violators and those overstaying for the stay in the country. The amnesty program is expected to benefit hundreds of illegal foreign workers, including Indians overstaying their permits, by allowing them to leave the country without penalties. The overstaying residents will be able to exit the country without paying fines, or they can rectify their status by extending their visa during the amnesty period, which runs from 31st of October 2018. The UAE is home to 2.8 million Indian expatriates, the largest expatriate community in that country. The UAE government did not release a specific numbers, but said that thousands of people, primarily laborers from countries like India, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, Nepal and the Philippines, will benefit from the amnesty scheme, which will facilitate their smooth return to their home countries. The UAE previously granted two of such visa amnesties in 2007 and 2013, benefiting some 3,40,000 foreigners. Let's get you all the sporting action now. India will lock horns with Ireland in the quarterfinals of the Women's Hockey World Cup in London tonight. The Indian Eves had defeated Italy 3-0 in the playoffs to book a place in the last eight of the World Cup for the first time since 1978. Before beating Italy on Tuesday, India had finished the group stage at the third spot in Pool B, and Ireland were in the same group and had defeated India 1-0 before ending as the table toppers and directly qualifying for the quarterfinals. Now, the semifinals will be played on Saturday and the final is slated for Sunday. And in cricket, India restricted England to 285 for 9 at stumps on day one of the first cricket test of the 5-match series at Edgbaston. Off-spinner R. Ashwin took 4 wickets as the hosts lost 6 wickets for just 69 runs in the final session of the play to find themselves in a precarious position after opting to bat first. Mohammad Shami also clinched 2 crucial wickets. Joe Root scored 80 runs, but the English innings completely got derailed after his dismissal. Johnny Bairstow made 70 runs and Sam Curran was batting on 24 with James Anderson for company at stumps. News from the world of badminton, PV Sindhu, Kidambi Srikanth and Sai Praneeth notched up contrasting wins to progress to the pre-quarterfinals of the World Badminton Championship in China. Olympic silver medalist PV Sindhu opened her campaign with an easy win over her Indonesia's Fitriani, and she will face Korean Seung Ji Hyun in the next round. Ace Indian shuttler Kidambi Srikanth overcame unseeded Pablo Abian of Spain to move into the third round of the tournament. And B. Sai Praneeth also entered the next round after defeating Spain's Luis Enrique Penbalver to set up a meeting with Denmark's Hans Christian Whittinghus. That's it from me and my team in this edition of Breakfast News. Thanks for watching.